Hey, fame, sir.
To Chad with this weapon in the end of May.
Right.
They're due to fire the weapon in the Glen of Amal on Tuesday of next week. So they're in the final stages of their training.
Yeah. So they don't do any, there's no firing done?
No. Anything of that caliber will be in the Glen of Amal.
Arthur, is there a heavy mortar troop in Chad?
No. At the moment, the 81 is the caliber of the weapons. Yeah.
Can I just ask you about, you know, you said that last December you took possession of six more 120s. Have you got enough ammunition now and that?
Yes. That's
secure.
Full package. And all of the ancillary equipment. However, it was a really good deal.
Very good. Delighted to hear that.
And there was a huge number. I think we got 80 in total.
Yeah.
But they're spread nationwide.
He's been a hard report here.
Number one here on the side is Private Fallon. He's number one. Number two is the ammunition number, which is Private Maxwell. And three is responsible for the bipods, i.e. moving the mortar left or right, is Private Ennis. And from there here, ammunition number, Private Carey. This course over here, it's the entry course. It's course that all the gunners here must have for the private mission to Chad. The majority of these guys here are from Chad. We have a shoot now in the Glen of Amal on Thursday, the 2nd, which will be the completion of the course, which will see the training complete for overseas movement.
These are all young soldiers that are within 2 years of actually joining.
Great.
So this will be their last of what we call their qualifying courses.
Right.
The item here is in the old days, when you were giving out fire orders and angles and bearings and whatever, they were all come out by megaphone. Now it's all done by line and it comes down in digital format. So,
I think
the lads are very good at it.
See, there's all the shouting.
So there are six of these tubes deployed in Chad, and these gents will be taking over those in May from the Southern Brigade, from the Cork Regiment that are out there at the moment.
And they already have this equipment out there, have they?
They have the equipment is all pre-positioned, so they hand it over. The tour in Chad will be 4 months.
Right.
Okay, normally overseas missions are 6 months, but because of the environmental hazards, etc.
How many actually have we had in Chad at the moment?
We have a full battalion, so we're up on about 300 in total.
Is there a young chap by the name of Jeremy Mahon here? Jeremy Mahon?
Yeah.
I'd like him to meet him.
He's waiting for his audiogram.
This young chap's late grandfather actually served with the 38th Battalion now in the Congo, they're involved now with 120 and so just kind of history of like the repeating stuff now. The grandson and the grandfather have previously served
there. There is a huge family tradition, isn't there?
In garrison towns like this, there is a huge family tradition. I think that battery sergeant Gibby and his father would have been the military police sergeant.
Number one, fire!
Now, can we take coffee, give you a cup of coffee?
Yeah, that's great, yeah, lovely. Yeah. I don't know if it's from these minutes or what.
Huh?
Thank you.
was all. Just once again, I want to formally welcome Deputy Eamon Gilmore, leader of the Labour Party, here this morning. He done a short visit to the Mullingar area, ably escorted by Councillor Dollard here. He's going to say a few words to you now. Thank you.
Thanks very much indeed. Well, first of all, thank you for your welcome to Columb Barracks and for taking time to show me around and explain what you're doing and explain the history of this barracks and its importance in the Defence Forces. The reason I'm here is that the Labour Party is having a conference this weekend. It's our annual conference. We're having it in the Mullingar Park Hotel. Deputy Willie Penrose had been bending my ear for quite some time to take the Labour Party conference to Mullingar, and Councillor Dollard and our local representatives here have been doing the same. And we're delighted to have done so. So we'll be here until Sunday, about 1,200 delegates. The only slight difficulty we've had so far is getting accommodation for all of them. But I understand that you have accommodation here for an extra almost 200. And if we'd have known that last week, we'd have been sending you some of our delegates. I'm delighted to be here. It's great. Thank you for the welcome. It's great to see the work preparation, particularly that's going on for the mission to Chad. This country is very fortunate in the Defence Forces that we have, and we're particularly proud, those of us who have the honour to represent the public in Dáil Éireann. We are proud of the work that our Defence Forces do on our behalf and the way in which our country is served abroad by our Defence Forces. I want to wish the mission which is going to Chad well, and to come back safely, and to say that we will be thinking of them while they are there. I also know that this barracks is a special place in the life and minds and love of the people of Mullingar. I think the welcoming signs that there are to Mullingar, which welcome people to the home of the 4th Field Artillery, I think are the only signs of its kind, I think, anywhere in Ireland. I think that demonstrates the connection and affection that there is between the town and the barracks. And that is, I think, as it should be, because I know that there's been long family traditions associated with this barracks and with the work that is done here. I think that's a very important thing, that, you know, that connection is, and that connectivity is there. So I'm glad to be here. I won't hold you up from your day's work. It's a great pleasure to be here, and I hope that I have the opportunity of coming back again in the not too distant future. Thank you very much.
Just before you go, the Sergeant Major would like to make a small momento.
Thank you very much.
Every time you look at this, and remember the 4th Regiment in Mullingar.
I will indeed, yes.
And we'll be watching out for the toy in the Raptors of Tower.
I might even wear it tomorrow night, given this speech.
It's deemed that the 4th Field Artillery Regiment was actually held by the people on the Cuttlebus meeting. That's Pat Collins, who was then chair of the town council.
Sorry, and
Danny McLaughlin, yeah. County manager.
Yeah.
So that's a nice bilingual.